Don, the auction professor here. Just a quick update and some other issues. Very important today. I did talk to eBay today about the glitches. I had a few more photos disappear, so I didn't want to be behind on the ball on this, so I did call. I actually got a person who I've talked to many times on the phone, and there is a memo at eBay right now that was given out to all of the customer service reps, from what I'm understanding. It was as of today, just today, July 2nd, and they had admitted to the issue at this point. I don't think this was released to the general public yet, but you did read off a lot of what it says. I wrote it down just so I didn't get any of the information wrong. There are 27 million listings that had photo issues related to this event. 830,000 actual individual sellers had items that had the photos disappear. And of that, about 32.2 averaged errors per actual seller. Now, that's what the totals were. They completely understand what the issue is. There is a link broken between the URL of your photos and where it links to the actual listings. They're on different servers, just what I had thought in the past, how it works. The photos are on one server. They're linked through URLs to the other server. I do have an IT background, so I did get into this. Luckily, the person who I talked to on the phone does know some about internet and some of the IT issues related to it, and she's worked at eBay for a while. So we talked a few minutes about this. The hopes of getting your photos back are very, very slim. I know enough to say that if the URLs are gone and the listings have been a little while past, that you may have relisted or anything like that. So the minute the listing is relisted or addressed or done something to it, you could have a new address for your actual listing in their system. Nothing you would see, but it would actually completely break any chance of them getting the URL back to your listing. So if your photos are missing, I would honestly say it's pretty much a done given that they are gone. And I, you know, talked to eBay literally today, just about an hour or so ago. I had planned on shooting this live, but for whatever reason, YouTube is totally acting up, and I could not go live. I tried for an hour. I'm not going to mess with it, so I'm shooting out this video this way. But again, it is a confirmed thing. It has since been fixed with the photo issues, but fixing the issue and stopping it from happening is not going to bring your photos back. The URL, again, the address where your photos are, is gone. It's broken. They still have all of the images, but there's no physical way to bring them back to your listings. And this is literally, as I said, from eBay itself, from a rep that I've talked to. So the issues have all been found. They know what the issues are. They're addressing the issues as it happens. And again, I had faith that that would be, again, if anybody in any business lost the URL linkage to those items and those items changed, there's just no way to get it back. I don't think that's a technical thing that you could actually do, from all the experience that I have. And I have taken, you know, internet, and, you know, I know HTML, I know CSS, database, the whole works. I completely understand how this works, for the most part, all the aspects of this. I don't see them getting your photos back. You know, and again, as I said, I just talked to eBay, and this form was just announced to internal employees today. A couple other issues, too. There are new glitches that they haven't addressed as of yet. Now, these glitches are just in the policies. While I was going through just to make sure I didn't have any more major issues on photos, which I only had a couple, I looked through a bunch of listings. I couldn't find any more other than, say, seven or so total. And I still have one photo, so it's not a huge ordeal for me. But I ran into some other glitches. As of right now, the policies, eBay policies for returns, for payments, and shipping are down for anybody newly who hasn't subscribed to it, so you can't do it right this moment because there is a glitch. Now, for anybody who has policies, it's not a big ordeal at all. If you find any that are like that, all you got to do is act like you're going to fix them and go to a relist to check them, and they'll just go away, all the errors with it. I don't know what the deal was, but it's not anything that was a major glitch, and none of this has actually affected me, other than, you know, a few photos being gone. And I don't worry about the views, so the view count and loss isn't anything. If you want to see if you're getting viewed and if your item is out, there's a simple, easy way to do it. Log off everything on your system in your computer. Log off your web browser, log off eBay, clear your cookies, and clear your complete browser history and all the dump files, and then look on, go back to eBay and actually just randomly, you know, look as if you're nobody. Don't log in, don't do anything, and type in part of the words in your title description of the items you're curious about. You know, I did this for the ones that didn't have photos, and you know, I looked to make sure there wasn't any other things going on. They all show up. So, you know, it's just a matter, again, of a link issue. The whole issues that it sounds like are all issues related to actual URL addresses or linkage from one system to another. And again, this can happen in any system on the planet, and I've seen it in many, many other places before. I kind of assumed that something like that was going on. As soon as I heard that it was a URL issue, that's what it is. So again, they have found the issue. They've had found the issue for a little while. They've estimated, they know exactly how many listings were affected, and that's what we're at this point too. So again, shouldn't happen again. They know what the issue is. They've fixed the issue. They've stopped the seepage of these losses in the URLs, but I don't really see them fixing it. One other issue that was not available on June 1st, which you will definitely need to go in and do right away if you do not want to get hit by any heavy returns. We, again, do the 30-day free returns where I pay for the returns. On June 1st, you're required to do that. But they did not have an option for you to be able to go in and only do free returns for U.S. shipping. So if you set up 30-day returns on June 1st where it was free by you, you should go back in immediately and go into your return policy and check down at the bottom. They've now separated where you have a U.S. return policy and a international return policy. So what you want to do is go down to the international return policy and click that the buyer pays return shipping, and boom, you're all set. That's if you're set up in policies. So just keep that in mind. I do not know if you can go in and multi-edit it to get that feature in on your individual listings without going on and like grouping them at 500 at a time. So if you only have a few listings, no big deal. But again, if you're using policies, which is the easiest way to do any of these changes, again, it's temporarily down. It may be up by the time you check it today. But if you're using this and you want to do it where you take the 30 days, set up the policies if it's available, and then adjust it so you're not taking free returns from overseas. Again, if you already have the policies, simply go in there and adjust your return policy for your business policies, which is under the listings section in the hub. Go to listings, bottom left-hand corner, you'll see business policies. That's where I set up everything now. It's quick and easy. It took 10 seconds for me to go in there and alter my return policy to block all free returns from international shipping. Now, those are the main issues. Again, I tried to get this out live a little while ago. YouTube is down live. I am going to shoot for my YouTube live Wednesday night show. But if there, for some reason, there is not a functionality in running live for me, I'm trying to get it fixed. YouTube isn't great on getting back with you. So I already have another video ready, so it's something different. So I will go with that if anything happens. So just keep that in mind. So if you don't see me on by 7:10, chances are I'll be going to running a secondary video, which I will up ahead of time, so there'll at least be something to watch. Again, I tried to go live today, but we have issues. So again, that's an update on the glitches. eBay is fully aware. Whether they've admitted it publicly, which I haven't seen anyone else talk about it, so I'm guessing at this point this is something that, you know, the rep I talked to may or may not have known to tell me that. You know, it might be internal information. I don't know. And one other quick thing here. I've talked to some people. I put out a video not too long ago about some of these glitches and talked about the call center phone that I always get an American person. I always get American service here from California. I asked that same question. Why is that I hear other people getting Philippine phone calls in, you know, other places of call centers? If you have an anchor store, you are guaranteed U.S. representation at the call center, no matter what. So that explains why I always get call center talk from an American citizen. In the past, there was only a call center here that most of the calls would have went through regardless, but a few years ago, from what I've understood and what this person has told me, the eBay rep, who's worked there for years, they changed this a few years ago. So anybody who has the anchor store gets direct access from the U.S. call center. All other calls can be routed to the Philippines or wherever their call centers are. It doesn't mean they're going to be, but in high peak flow times, which they are now with all the glitches, they are routed overseas for the most part, or can be. But again, for those of you with anchor stores, you have nothing to worry about. It's built into the price, apparently, and that is why the price is a little higher for us, I guess. But again, that's how it works. So for those of you who are getting overseas calls, that is why I don't get them. It's an added service included in with the $350 per anchor store I pay. So we pay $700. I guess that's a good bonus that I always get someone American. And I honestly get the same person numerous times. So good thing. That's another reason to be friendly with eBay. I got some information here today that most people probably wouldn't get because they're not going to offer the information. I talked to this person quite a few times. She's very polite, very nice. She's very, very, very helpful. She's went over and above the aspect of this, and we've talked outside of this too. So it's a good thing to be friendly with somebody on eBay and to get this report. But that's what I have for you today. Again, Don the Auction Professor. If you liked the video, please hit like below. Hit the bell icon up top if you'd like to be notified of future videos and live feed. And subscribe and tell a friend.